Hey, I got 7 online business ideas for you. I'm going to give you a little help on how to get started. Maybe you're not sure what to do, where to start. Well, you've come to the right video, and just hang out. I'm going to make this really quick. So let's get going. My name's Lamar Schoell. I'm from Direction to Success. Man, and I love it. Having a great day so far. Look, if you want to see more videos just like this on online businesses, subscribe to the Direction to Success channel. Hit that button down below. Also, look, if you get some value, do me a favor, hit that like button. You can drop a comment down below the video, whatever you want. If you just want to say hi, or if there's a question, or maybe, as usual, I might have messed something up. All right, now let's get into this. What I want to do is go over, I think it's 7, I didn't really count them. Not good at math, what can I say? So, no, seriously, I don't know. I put a list together and I want to help you with this. And the first thing you want to do before you start any online business, you want to play off of your strengths. What do I mean? Well, find something or some things you're already good at. Don't go where you think there's the money, right? Because I'm going to tell you why. If you find something you're already good at and you're passionate about, it's going to help with you staying in the game. This is why a lot of people quit. They keep their mind or eyes focused on just the money. They say, I've got to do learn how to do this or do this because there's so much money. Well, I think if you're doing any online business, any of these ideas, you're going to have the potential to make good money. And we're going to get through. We'll talk a little bit about that when we go through these 7 ideas. I think there's 7. So, the Allure is really amazing, right? Making money online, living your own life, right? Being free, having that laptop freedom lifestyle, calling your shots. Well, I mean, I think that's all everybody looks at, right? When they want to start looking at a business online. But listen, I'm just gonna be honest with you, man. It's not far from that, right? You can think of like an online business as like, say you got this big boulder in front of you right now, this big, humongous folder, I don't know, boulder, and you wanna just push it, right? Think about how hard you're gonna probably have to put your shoulder into it. Think about how hard, how much energy that will take just to get that boulder started. But once it starts rolling, it's gonna be easier to maintain, right? To keep it in motion. But then if it stops again, you've got to go through all that. So it's like that's just exactly how an online business is. At first, you've got to put all this work into it. And it's hard with, to keep going because you're probably not seeing the results you were looking for, right? At the beginning. But once you stay in flow and you keep it going, it does get easier and better over time. And I think this is why a lot of people quit. And this is why you've got to pick something that you're already good at and definitely passionate about. Okay, now with that being said, let's get into some of these 7 ideas. The first one here is if you're already like a software geek, and this is kind of where I come from, right? So this is why I wanted to put this one first. You can actually create websites for different companies, right? So, I mean, whether the company's big or single person companies, right? Just that have an online business, there are so many businesses every year that get started. You could go to these businesses and say, hey, I will develop your website for you. And just kind of tell them, hey, this is a great thing to have. They probably already know it, right? But they just don't have the talent, the skill to do it. That's where you would come in. Along those same lines, you could also develop sales funnels for all these companies. And it doesn't matter how big or how small the company is or what products or services they have, they all need a website. They all need sales pages. Now, the other thing is, that's pretty cool, ClickFunnels makes sales pages easy. So if you're not the software geek, you can actually get really good at sales funnel. And it's not that hard. Sales funnels is pretty easy. I use it for about 8 months. And I'm telling you, it's simple. You don't have to know HTML. You don't have to know CSS. You don't have to know JavaScript. You don't even have to know what those words are, right? But with ClickFunnels, it just really makes it easy. So you could get good at ClickFunnels and go to companies and say, I will create your sales funnels for you, right? That's pretty easy. So that's idea number one. Idea number two, if that's not your thing, what about an e-commerce store, opening up a Shopify store, right? It's very, very easy nowadays. You can go to distributors like Alibaba or AliExpress, right? So what you would do is buy the products from them at a cheaper price and then turn around and just sell them for a higher price. This is where your profits come in. The nice thing about this, they both do drop shipping. So what drop shipping is, you don't have to maintain all these products and find storage and keep them around somewhere. They do all that. And when you sell one of those products, they ship it from their warehouse to your customer. That's pretty cool. They handle all the support, right? They get all the phone calls. If they're, you know, if shipping's late or whatever, right? Messed up somehow. They do all that. So that's pretty cool, right? So an e-commerce store, number two, right? Yeah, I think we're only on two. All right, let's try to go a little bit faster here. Virtual assistant, this is pretty cool, right? So there are lots of companies always looking for additional help from time to time, right? So if you're a good writer, say, you could actually do like blog posts, right? Blog posts for companies. A lot of times they don't have people that have, you know, are in, on their payroll or have time to go looking. But if you go to that, you know, a company or even just some business online and ask them, hey, I can do your writing for you, you know, your blog posts, I'll get them up there and all this, you know, there's a lot of money to be made there. Now, two good websites I just thought of were Freelancer and Fiverr. You can go to these websites and actually, you know, look on there and see what's available. Also, you can use these same websites to, you know, put yourself out there. This is where people are going to find you. Let them know, or you tell them using these websites what you do. People will go to those companies, will go to those websites and occasionally look for work. A lot of small business owners definitely do that. I know I have. I haven't used Freelancer, but I have used Fiverr. Upwork was another one. I've used those two from time to time. So Upwork would be another good site for you to use. What about this one? An ebook author, right? Say you love writing and you really know you're passionate about something, you're really good about something, sit down, write an ebook. There's so many programs out there today where once you write that content, you can really get that ebook styled like in no time. You don't have to pay somebody to do that. You can do this. The programs are reasonably priced. I mean, I think even under $100, if you want to buy a program to do that, you can put your front and back cover on there, use, you know, your branding colors through there. It will do all the formatting. It lays it out really nice. Now, once you're done, you don't even have to worry about finding a publisher. This is 2020, right? You've heard of Amazon, right? Oh, okay, of course you have. Who hasn't, right? But Amazon has another website. It's called like Amazon Publishing. Forget the exact name of it now. It has that Amazon look, and that's the other good thing about it, right? Because people are familiar with Amazon. So if your books are here, it has that same look and feel, but it's under some other name. But if you just type in Amazon Publishing in Google, you'll get there. But that's pretty cool. All you have to do is just simply upload your ebook there and just sit back. This is kind of like, you know, passive income, right? You don't have to do anything anymore. Now people are over or that much, right? People are on that website searching. They come up with your book, right? So, Amazon makes a little money. You make a little money. It's all good. Now, another one I want to talk about is freelancing. This has to do with what we just talked about a little bit. But if you already have skills that you don't have to be trained, like you're ready to go today, right now, guess what? Go to the two sites I just mentioned, a Freelancer and Fiverr. You can go there and, you know, just look for what people are trying to find, Put your skills up there. You know, let people know what you have to offer on these sites. They're really good at that. So this is how you get people to find you. Now, I saved the best one for last. I wish I knew the number, but I don't remember. So, but we'll just call it number 7, the best for last. Look, I love affiliate marketing, all right? And affiliate marketing is simply, you know, if you're an affiliate marketer, you're just selling somebody else's product, right? So they have to worry about the product. They've got to worry about, or not even worry about, but they handle all the, coming up with the training. They come up with all the resources you need to sell, such as a sales page. They do all this, right? So you don't have to worry about all this. They worry about all the checkouts. So you don't have to worry about any of that. The other thing I like about affiliate products, the commissions are generally higher. It obviously depends on the product, but they generally range from like 50%. They can go up to 80%. Imagine that. You don't have to worry about coming up with the product, nothing like that. It's all done. So this is something I find very lucrative, and it's actually really fun to do. Now, you can sell different type of products, meaning there's physical products, kind of like what we just talked about with e-commerce, and there's digital products. And myself, I prefer digital products because people can just click on a link and get to the product immediately, right? This could be a membership to a website, could be a video course, a PDF download, a software download, but it's all digital. So you don't have to worry about shipping or delays. It's just instantaneous. And that's one of the things I like about it. And you don't have to worry about creating your sales funnel. Like we talked about that, right? I think that was number 1. And email swipes, follow-up email. Most of the time, things like this are done for you. They might even go as far as to do banners for you, so like you could put them in your blog. Those are really good. Sometimes I've seen affiliate products also do social media posts done for you. All you have to do is just take their graphics, right, and just add it to or post it in a Facebook group or post it on your profile page. It's that easy. So that's one thing. That's why I like affiliate marketing as my number 1 choice out of the 6 or 7 or whatever it is we talked about today. But if you want to know more about affiliate marketing and the system I'm using, I've got the link down below. The thing I like about this system, all the tools you need are there for you. You don't need to go out and get anything else. You don't need an additional autoresponder. You don't need somebody to build your sales funnels for you because this is already done for you in this system. And if you want to check it out, click on that link below. There's a 1-week free trial. You don't have to enter your credit card. You can find out for yourself if this is for you. And they have high ticket offers in there, which I'm telling you, I want you to click on the link to go find out about the commissions yourself. But I think you're going to be amazed. If you do have any question, look, I've got my contact information down below in this video. Just get a hold of me. All right, I will see you on the next video. That means I will see you tomorrow.